My name is James Port. I'm 72 years old, and in April of this year, through an elevated PSA test, I was diagnosed with possible prostate cancer. My normal doctor from St. John's recommended that I come see Dr. M. So I made an appointment. He suggested that I do a MRI, then an MRI with contrast, and then a biopsy. They discovered that I had one lesion on my right upper side of my prostate. They suggested that I go for the biopsy, which I did. They thought at that time that I would just wait and watch. It was early and they were not too concerned. A couple of months later, I went for a follow-up PSA test. So I came back here and they decided that the best thing for me to do was to take another MRI with the contrast. They discovered that I had three lesions instead of the one. So at that point, after talking with a couple of my friends that had their prostate removed, I came back and I talked to M, and I explained to him that maybe the best thing to do was not to go any further, but just to have it removed. And in fact, we had made an appointment with Dr. Timothy Wilson, who was also recommended to us, and that I had a date for a possible surgery coming up. He slowed me down, convinced me and my wife, who is my true partner in this whole event. He suggested that I wait and take another test, which would reveal the BRCA gene, cancer gene, if I had it. Turns out that I did not. In that particular meeting, I came to get the blood test and I was explaining to whom I thought was his assistant that I was very confused. I was just fit to be tied and thought that I should just go forward with having it removed. He began to explain to me that, in his opinion, because my friends who were lawyers and mechanics and engineers and plumbers were not doctors, and that he was, and that this was his specialty. So he suggested that I wait. And after we got the results back from the bracket, he suggested the same advice that he would give his father, which was, you don't need to have your prostate removed at this time. Let's do the HIFU technique, which is what I'm familiar with and which I'm very good at. And I think that would be the best remedy for where we are right now. He was of the mind that this might be a little premature, that we should stop and take a look at the whole picture rather than just going in a direction that there was no coming back from. Yes, having it removed would eliminate any chance of cancer, but having your prostate removed brings up its own set of criteria that changes your life at this point forward. So that's when we started to learn about this HIFU procedure that he does. He felt confident that this was the way to go. So we switched to that, and we thank Dr. Wilson very much for meeting with us, giving us the information, and giving us the opportunity to change the direction that we were going in. It wasn't as if he was looking for another notch on his belt. He was looking out for me personally going forward. So my wife and I talked about it. We decided that we were going to go ahead. We got scheduled for an October the 10th date of this year. The procedure was very well explained. The girls in the office were tremendous. His staff is absolutely professional and very helpful. It's like you become a member of the family. So the morning of the 10th, I showed up. My wife brought me. It was supposed to be a two-hour procedure. They give you full anesthesia, so I have no idea about remembering no more than being rolled in and then waking up a couple of hours later. No pain at all. catheter was inserted. If you've never had one, it's a treat. They're extremely uncomfortable, and it's just something you have to live with for a couple of weeks. So the bottom line is they take care of everything for you. They give you the proper medicine. They check up on you. You're not on your own ever. You're a phone call away. The portal is an amazing thing. Never once did we go, I would say 12 hours was a long time not to be answered. But if you did it after hours or in the middle of the night, you got a response back the next day. First thing, before he started working. He may be a very, very busy doctor, but he's busy with his patients. So now I'm in a little hiatus. I've got 3 months to go before I get another PSA test to decide whether they got it all, whether it's a reduced level. I feel great. I'm comfortable, happy. I really tried not to put in my head that this was going to be a major procedure. And it's a procedure, not surgery. So there was no cutting. And I thought that my pain threshold was pretty good. And I thought that I was pretty healthy, and I thought I could handle it. My wife had to keep reminding me daily after the procedure that I had just gone through a general anesthesia, that I had been knocked out for 2 to 3 hours, that I had a major procedure done, and that I was exhausted. I thought that I would be able to get up and go to work the next couple of days. I thought I could stay home a couple of days. I thought I'd be okay. I had never had a catheter before. It was definitely unfamiliar, uncomfortable with the procedure. I thought that I was okay, but in reality, it took me 3-4 days to really get my feet back underneath me. And with having the catheter, not being able to get a good night's sleep, not being able to get my rest, it was an experience that I don't wish on anyone. The most important thing is, as an individual, if you're thinking about doing this, find out what it is, find out what it's all about, and get a full picture. It's important to be realistic with where you are in your life cycle, and to know you've got to do what's best for you, and that's what they're there for, to give you the information, to give you a complete picture, and then you need to make your decision. The best thing you can have is a family team at home, and then the next best thing is a family team of your professionals. I can't thank Dr. M enough for his support. It would be my pleasure at any point in time to be his friend. He made me feel as if he was not only competent, but this was what he does. And you can tell by the way he does it, he loves it. And it's a great relief to know that I'm in good hands. The whole team was phenomenal. The checkups, the follow-ups, everything was great. So once again, thank you, Dr. M, for all of your concern, your ability to put me at ease, and your ability to do what you do best. And I'm glad of my decision. And anyone that's interested in getting this done should. It's a great opportunity, and I can't thank them enough for doing it. I look forward to living the next 30 years in health and in happiness, and thanking Dr. M every day.